the Ron and Fez show. We have sneers on our faces, and we're kind of throwing our fists in the air right now.
Pick it up.
I actually sing the song.
Let's see you sing it now, Mikey.
Hey, little sister, what have you done? Hey, little sister, who's your number one?
Where's the Ron Fez, what is it, the RonFez.net, Ben?
Right.
When's their next big appearance?
Sometime in July. We're working something out.
Woo! Let's make it a Saturday so Fez and I can be there.
Absolutely.
And you're going to be lead singing?
I will be most of the lead singing. We also have a female singing as well.
Do you come out from behind the drum kit when you sing?
No, I do not.
Like Tommy Lee used to when he would play the piano for Home Sweet Home. We'd all go crazy.
No, I sing and play the drums.
Bum, 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 bum. And I don't care who you were. Not a dry eye in the house, Fezzy.
Sure. Not with everyone that messed up.
You know, why does it always have to come back to putting other people down for enjoying music? No, would you do this for me? Could you at least save one song for El Jefe to sing lead?
No.
Come on.
Well, what is he? Why should he sing?
All right.
As an olive branch.
For what he's doing with the music. How he fixed the music.
Well,
you can't stop the music. I don't know who said that. I think it was in some disco thing, can't stop the music.
I could think about, like, what song he could
I
do.
I know, maybe. Because you're setting him up to be mean, and I know.
Right. You could have been nice and said, yeah, I'd love to have El Jefe step out and do a number with us.
And that would have meant a lot to Fez and I.
I'm sorry.
All right, you were going to do a trivia contest and give away what, Mikey?
There you go, Mikey.
Any my business?
Oh, no. We're going to give out a pair of tickets to see Aerofest 2003 featuring Journey, REO Speedwagon, and Styx on Wednesday, July 23rd.
All right.
At MCI Center.
Oh, good.
You know you're not supposed to do the plugs.
Oh. Know that.
I'm sorry.
You know it's supposed to be me saying Aerofest 2003, Journey, REO Speedwagon, Styx, Wednesday, July 23rd at the MCI Center. So you have a trivia question pertaining to Aerofest 2003?
I sure do.
All right, let's hear it.
Okay. A member of one of the bands of Aerofest 2003 played a key role in the demise of the title character in this musical. Name the member and the musical.
Okay, I'm having a little trouble following the question.
Okay. The questions.
One of the members of one of the bands of Aerofest 2003.
All right, someone appearing on Aerofest 2003.
Correct. Played a key role in the demise of the title character of the musical that he was in.
Like cats? Somebody killed a cat? You
right.
Mean? I'm very confused.
There's like, you know, like.
My dad killed a cat one time.
All you're saying is one of the guys in these bands played on Broadway?
Yes, and a national tour.
Okay, so one of the performers.
So did he play on Broadway or a national tour?
When he played in New York, it was at the Felt Forum or the theater at Madison Square Garden. That's considered Broadway.
By who?
The theater at Madison Square Garden is considered Broadway?
Oh, sure.
By who?
That's a big venue.
I know it's a big venue.
Madison Square Garden's a huge venue, but it's not considered Broadway.
I have heard that it is. The theater is now Broadway.
Theater.
Well, I guess if you're going to say theater that way, I guess it is Broadway.
All right, call in and win these tickets right now, 866-277-4969.
So you have to know the performer who's at Aerofest 2003.
Correct.
And what musical he appeared in on Broadway.
Or off, and then in a touring show. All right, here's Jim. Jim, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Jim.
After hearing that, I've decided to become a heroin addict again. I have no idea what he's talking about.
Now Jim's back on the smack.
Oh, that's too bad, Jim.
Just let me know if you want me to have El Jefe come up with a contest. It won't be a problem.
You know, the reason Billy didn't get picked is because I didn't need a nutty question with a nutty no answer.
It's factual. It's true.
I know, but we just need to.
It's satisfactual.
We got to understand what you mean. Here's Dave. Dave, you're on the air.
Hey, Dave.
George Bush and Saddam Hussein.
All right. They're mocking us out now.
I think that goes back to the enemy's lunch.
Here's Jeff.
I was just wondering how damn queer do you have to be to answer that question?
Mikey? How queer.
I know. It's a rock thing. Why is it back to theater and Broadway? And I'm just guessing Cats.
It's not, you know, it's not my fault that the guy did theater, you know.
It's a theater.
Why all of a sudden?
I'm sorry.
Here's Jason. Jason, you're on the air.
Hey, Jason.
Hey, Ron and Fez. Yeah. Hey, Fez, bachelor party this week.
We will talk about that. Why don't we talk about it tomorrow, Fez?
All right, we will do that.
I know there's some controversy right now.
Yeah, there is actually a problem.
All right, we'll talk about that tomorrow. That's a promise. Here's Kurt. Kurt, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron and Fez, how's it going?
Good.
What
do
you
have an answer?
Yeah, Dennis DeYoung of Styx played Pontius Pilate in Jesus Christ Superstar.
I can't believe someone got that stupid-ass question.
And he even named the role that he was playing in Jesus Christ Superstar. Great work, Kurt.
You've become so weird, Mikey.
You have gotten stranger over the week.
Yeah, and you used to be our most normal guy, and now you come in for some fake talk. And I really feel like... like we're doing an improv instead of having a conversation. Yes, he's in theater now.
You have made Billy seem extra normal in the past 2 weeks.
That, Fezzy, is the meanest thing you've ever said to anybody.
Now, sir, you have insulted me.
Now, see that thing, that now, sir. What does that mean?
Where is it coming from?
Are you an Englishman in New York suddenly? Are you Sting?
I'm a bod.
Why don't you put together another one? We'll give out another pair of tickets.
Okay.
And not so crazy.
All right, I'll try not to make it that crazy.
Let's do this. Let's rock.
Let's rock.
You know, let's not bring everything back to the legitimate stage.
Which I don't think the theater at Madison Square Garden is.
Well, national tour and the theater at Madison Square Garden. But that holds more people than some Broadway houses.
No. So what?
Then does it make it Broadway?
Kiss has drawn more than Broadway houses, but it doesn't make them musical theater.
Well, because it's probably a touring, you know, show. They don't have a theater on Broadway, per se.
Was it eligible for a Tony?
I don't think so, because it's a remake.
Yes, a revival.
It's a revival, that's it.
And that is eligible for a Tony.
Oh, well.
I know that from the game being so boring the other night. I clicked over and watched the revival award go on. All right, give us a couple of minutes and come back with another one.
Okay.
Okay. Rock it up, okay?
I'll rock it up.
Like a drummer.
A drummer.
Yeah, a rocker.
Okay.
Yeah. You're Marty Jannetty, you're a rocker.
You think this is when Cameron took away the music?
Mm-hmm.
This is a little too fruity?
Yeah. I guess so.
Oh, listen to this. Listen to what Mikey's putting on now. This is what happened, Mikey. This kind of music.
Oh, that's good stuff.
I know. Pretty hands. What was that guy's name?
George Benson.
No, but what was the guy who directed this in... from all that jazz?
Bob Fosse.
Yeah, Bob Fosse. It's showtime.
I knew Bob Fosse.
You're acting like Bob Fosse, and it's amazing.
You're acting like Twyla.
How did you know Bob Fosse?
He did Chicago when I was on Broadway, the original Chicago.
Yeah.
So I met him.
Oh, not the Richard Gere one.
But that's not the same as you know him.
Well, I mean, I hung out with him a few times. We hung out at Sardi's.
I love the references.
Who would say me and Bob Fosse hung out at Sardi's?
We had lunch. It was beautiful.
Maybe Helen Hayes.
And Anne Rankin, too.
Any heterosexuals show up at all?
I'm sure there was someone.
Now, Mikey.
Not even the waiters.
Mikey, now we will all take a look at my balls. They're delightful, young man.
He's a hell of a guy.
Was he?
Yes, he was. He was a nice guy.
I don't know what to say.
Sorry.
Is it going to be Fosse trivia when you come back?
You never know.
Fez, I forgot to tell you, I once had a brunch with George M. Cohan.
You're kidding.
Oh, he was a grand old fag. You're nuts, Mikey. All right, go get us a rock question.
Let me go get it.
Thank you, Mikey D.
Rock it up. Be a rock dog. This is going to stink.
Yeah, it's just going to be as bad as the last one.
I used to put him on the highest possible level.
When did he go insane?
When they took his music away. You know what I want?
Give it back to him.
You know what I want for tomorrow night? I want his crazy audio diaries. And let's do this. You and I will pick the dates, and he has to show up with them instead of he himself. Because I bet there's a lot of rips on Ron and Fez in there.
Oh, yeah.
I bet there's a lot.
There's some nasty stuff. I'd like the one a couple Saturdays ago, he took me out to dinner. And I bet that is just a hell of an audio diary. And Lord knows what I said. I was liquored up.
Yeah, he complained about that.
I know.
How many 77s did he buy you? And you know what? If you need money...
I think I had three.
When you go out like that, come to me, and I'll give you the money. And then
I had the money. I was invited out to eat.
But I don't want to hear about it.
I'm sure I had three or four at the most. That's what I remember.
I heard Baker's Dozen.
Yeah, it was close to like 10, 11.
Oh, there was not that many sevens and sevens.
Oh, yes, there was.
Are you afraid to bring in the audio diaries?
No, I'll bring it in.
Well, I know
but it's hard to look up specific dates. It's going to take me a little time.
I'd like things
from
the past.
Why, to recut them, isn't it?
No, I have. You know how many little microcassette tapes I have?
Oh, well, I'm talking over the last couple of weeks.
Oh, then that's fine. Then I can get those.
Yeah, as
that's
the nettiness grew.
Yeah, because all the breakdown was the last few weeks.
Ask Normal Billy for some help if you need it.
No,
let's stop acting like he's normal. I don't care if Mikey lights his ass on fire and rides a unicycle. Billy's not normal. Harvey, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Yeah.
Hey, Harvey.
Hey, I just want to let you know that Actors Equity Guidelines for the City of New York states that any house with 500 seats or more is a Broadway house.
All right, so then let's say Yankee Stadium is a Broadway house.
If you put on a show there, it would be under Broadway rules.
All right.
All right. The seventh inning stretch.
So anything more than 500 seats in New York is Broadway.
Absolutely. And then it goes to off-Broadway and off-off-Broadway. And it's
and that's more the size of the theater than where it's located.
Anything else, right.
Okay.
Because there's a lot of stuff on 42nd Street, too. It's not
right.
on Broadway.
I just thought you had to be in a legitimate theater
right.
to be Broadway,
yeah.
not just, rent out an armory.
That's a good point.
I mean,
wrestling can't be Broadway.
It's a show. It's an original.
Yeah. What else were we hoping to talk about here, Fez?
We're going to talk about Juicy Busey.
That's the new I'm with Busey that started last night. The new reality show on Comedy Central. And it's a young comedy writer and America's favorite actor, Gary Busey.
And they hang out, and it's this kid, and he just films his adventures with Gary Busey. That last night, they went and played paintball together. Busey gave him a tour of the house, and for some reason, Busey was in drag. He wanted to walk around dressed as a woman, and they went to a dance club.
Fez, what did you think of the show?
I thought it was fairly fake and pretty forced.
I, as you know, picked this as a huge hit. And 2 minutes into it, I'm going, why am I watching this crap? And how can I face Fez after telling him that this was going to be a hit? They torpedoed my radio psychic. No way will people watch this. You know what Busey reminds me of? I had a friend who was insane. He was crazy. He was a lunatic. And when he went to the Army, he goes, I want to be able to get out of this. I'm going to act like I'm insane. And I'm going, you don't have to act like you're insane. So Busey is a crazy person attempting to act crazy. And that's just boring.
Yeah, it really is. It was the stuff where they went and ate oysters. And Gary Busey's letting all the juice and everything run down his chin. All right, Gary Busey, he's a madman, sure. He's not. He doesn't really eat like that. It's fake. It's not real.
It's nuts. And he's wearing too much makeup. And he acted like he didn't recognize the guy when he came. And
then all of a sudden decided, that he would give out all the information at once to show how crazy he is. This show actually reminded me he's doing a bad Stone Cold impression. He actually did. He did the what thing. This show, if you watch it, anyone watches I'm with Busey, the kid who's the tag-along looks to me just like Harry Elvis. This looked like Harry Elvis and Stone Cold Steve Austin doing a show together.
That's all Harry ever wanted.
That's his favorite thing. But the thing where he went to the mall and got women's clothes and then went out in a club, It's just, it's all made up. This isn't really what Gary Busey does, you know, for crazy kicks.
And Comedy Central should have some comedy in it. This thing is going to last as long as that Murray's Brothers fake show. With Bill Murray and Brothers.
Right, yeah, that's the golf show.
Yeah.
Four, or whatever it was called.
We Stink should have been the name of it.
The Sweet Spot, that was the name of it.
Harry, get in here. How come you're not on that other show that you told us you were going to be in Last Comic Eating? What happened with that? What happened with that, Harry?
And why do you look so much like the guy and I'm with Busey?
Well, the Alex...
Trebek?
No.
Alex De La Pena.
He got his gig through Jimmy Kimmel because he was working for
this
the
This Busey
show.
Thing?
Yeah.
Guy's not funny.
He stinks.
He's pretty bad.
There's not one joke. And you know what? He's fake, too. He's not afraid of Busey the way he acts like he does on the show.
And then, yeah, a couple... Like, at first he was supposed to be the straight man, and then he started going crazy at one point. And
right.
I tried fast-forwarding... And finally, I go, this stinks so bad. And I literally looked at my check, and I go, now I have to fake face Fez. And I hate to lose. And it has nothing to do with money, but I hate to pick something and then have that nag come in last. And I picked the nag.
But the show doesn't have to be as bad as it is. Let Gary Busey be Gary Busey.
They're telling him that it's too late now. Now Busey, his direction is all off. And you know this guy?
I'm only familiar with him after I did research on him just to find out who he was, and he was working.
Was this a paper you did for school?
No, I was just curious who this kid was and why at such a young age.
And why he looked so much like you?
I did notice that, yeah, that he sort of had the thick hair that I have.
Are you doing a show? I'm with Ray Wagner. Is that still going to happen?
No, that's just.
I'm with Ray.
That's just us hanging out. It's not really. Probably more entertaining than I'm with Pussy, though.
Why don't you call it I'm with Pussy? And you're following Big Pussy all around town.
I knew that show was going to be a bad idea from the start. It just looks silly. And they're trying to capitalize on the Osborne thing again, and people don't understand that the Osbornes are naturally that way. Not like Anna Nicole Smith and Gary Busey, where they're setting up projects for them to do to make it interesting.
I think Anna Nicole is naturally nuts and drugged out of her mind. I think Gary Busey is naturally nuts. I don't think you need to do this show the way they're doing it. I think Gary Busey's cool enough. If you followed him around, you would get stuff. But there's no need to make him act extra nuts and come after the kid with a spear when you know that wouldn't happen.
I saw a clip of his appearance on Jimmy Kimmel. He's like plenty nuts on his own. You know, he doesn't, like you're saying, he doesn't need to be propped up to look crazy.
Yes, that's just what exactly I just said.
Why do I have you come in and agree with Fez? What are you, Mr. Summary?
In summation, Whatley feels...
What Fez was trying to say in his old antiquated way. I don't need that, Harry. I need you to have your own brain and your own thoughts. And I'll depend on Fez to have his.
I was actually hoping it was going to be sort of a fake reality show, just like they did with that contest Searchlight.
That stunk. That stunk on ice.
That one I never even watched. That was supposed to be the takeoff for Project Greenlight.
I got two words for you that are synonymous with boredom. Dennis Leary.
I thought The Job was good on ABC. That was
I never
pretty,
saw it, but
it was pretty creative.
Mm.
The writing was good. It had a lot of funny. Every week was pretty...
Well, I do work during that period, so I missed it. I'm on the air here.
All right, Harry Elvis, you are a student of comedy. I don't know what you've learned, but you're a student of comedy.
He sits at the feet of Ray Wagner. That's that's his Socrates.
Socrates? What do you think of this? What's his name? Orlando Bloom? Orlando Jones? Yeah, that just got a late night show on...
He's a pretty funny guy. He started out on Mad TV. Well, he's very quick and creative, and he's not like I think.
Have
the way
you checked out this new show? It started Monday.
I saw
Monday.
Clips of it. They've done. I've seen some of the sketches that he did, and some of them were pretty funny. Like he did something about rainbow Band-Aids.
Yeah, I keep seeing that where it's like flesh-colored Band-Aids, and you can get it in Morgan Freeman, Freckled, and Halle Berry Java or Mocha or something. Yeah.
And I thought that was pretty funny. I think he's very like quick and. And he's not forceful, you know, like he's very comfortable there.
Now, his big deal was he was going to break the whole late-night format. No desk, nothing like that, just a big comfy couch.
Well, he's doing the Arsenio thing, basically. I mean, that's been done before.
All right, I just went and looked him up. He's hideous.
Orlando Jones?
Yes.
I never said he was pretty. I said he was...
No, I mean his comedy. He was an evolution, without a doubt, the worst, crappiest thing I've ever saw. He did the 7-Up commercials, and you act like you're talking about Richard Pryor.
Well, no, I'm not... His work on that TV was very funny, I thought.
If you watch Evolution, and I hate to use this term, but he really falls into a real stereotype there.
You know what? He should do a show called Stinks on Ice.
But let's not judge him on Evolution.
Because that was the hackest of all hack roles.
But, you know, the thing is,
it's going in my crotch.
You want to see him do the same step and fetch it act? Watch Bedazzled. He does the same damn thing. It's an embarrassment.
That's the term for it.
He's had to take a lot of roles for the cash.
What reason? Nobody can make you do anything.
Well, you know, he may not be getting all... He hasn't been yet. Now he's just getting into where people know him.
What are you, is the public defender?
I just think he's funny.
He's taking Scatman Crothers roles, where he's the guy, he's the African-American whose eyes bulge out and he freaks out and gets scared. That's stereotype.
That's probably, maybe, that's more maybe the writing of Hollywood that they're not creating the role.
What was his finest role? Drumline?
No.
Is that where he did his best work?
No, he did something Heights. I forgot what it was.
Withering?
No.
I'm afraid. I'm scared of Heights.
Liberty Heights. But that wasn't a comedy, though. It was more of like a dramatic thing. I don't remember who was. I totally forgot, but that was like his biggest. He was in The Replacements, which was a pretty bad film, but I thought he was funny in that.
He was cut out of Magnolia. I remember that. He had one scene as the crackhead in Magnolia. Liberty Heights. Let me check this out.
So on the IMDb on AOL for Broadband.
Adrian Brody was in it. I didn't say it. Why don't you get it for me, Harry?
All right, I'll go out and get that. But I think...
I mean now.
Oh, okay.
I don't want you to just go on and on about this guy. He stinks on ice. Unless I find out something else. Mikey, are we ready to give out your thing? All right, come on in.
Come back in, Mikey D.
Yeah.
All right, Mikey D's got another trivia question for tickets to Aerofest 2003 featuring Journey, REO Speedwagon, and Styx, all coming up July 23rd. That's a Wednesday at the MCI Center.
All right, it's 866-277-4969. 866-277-4969. Call in and win concert tickets. Mikey, do we know for a fact that this is... Have you checked on it?
Oh, yeah, I checked on it.
It's a legitimate question.
Legitimate as the last one.
With a precise, accurate answer?
Absolutely.
Not open to debate?
Not open to debate. Excuse me, debate. Why, was the last one open to the debate?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, I have to make sure before you ask it.
I'm being very defensive. I'm sorry.
Yes, you are. And this is not a defensive show.
And no, I don't know if Billy helped you.
No, but we're looking at the, the computer there. He's looking it up for me to make sure that everything is right.
All right, ask your question.
Okay. The question is...
Yeah, like a person.
Okay.
Stop talking that way. You didn't used to talk that way, Mike.
Why did you go nuts on us? The question, please.
And it also refers to Aerofest 2003.
Well, that's ducky.
What did REO Speedwagon name themselves after?
Where does the name REO Speedwagon come from?
Why are you looking at him that way? Suddenly, like, leaning back.
I just got the big... He leaned back in his chair, put his hands on his hips, and gave me the so there look. You didn't think it was a legitimate question, so there, in your fat face, Fezzy.
He literally looked like he had tights and was holding some kind of a fencing tool. You, sir, have been slapped with my verbal glove. All right, we're going to take a break and we'll be right back. 866-277-4969. The question one more time, Mikey.
What did REO Speedwagon name themselves after?
It's the Ron and Fez Show.